Hello everyone, welcome to Big Data Knowledge Hunt. In the today's video, we will be going to see the clustering part, that is the Navy by K-means clustering example. In the previous video, we have seen what is mean by K-means clustering. We have seen the theoretical part of K-means clustering. Also, we have undergone through the numerical part of the K-means clustering, the formula that is being used to calculate the clustering coefficient or the clustering part. Link to all that videos will be in the description as well as in the I section. You can go through it. So in the today's video, we will be seeing how the coding part is. So to start with the coding, here I have started the Jupyter notebook. So I am using the Anaconda and I have started the Jupyter notebook. So here we are using a simple data set. In the further videos, I will be using a ready-made data set where we will be seeing a detailed example. So for this, we are using a simple data set which contains two attributes, that is X and Y. And by using these two attributes, we will be calculating or we will be dividing these two data points into different clusters. So these So in the Jupyter notebook, first we have to import the basic files such as NumPy and Pandas. These will require to import the Excel or CSV file. So after that, here I have stored my file, which is my CSV file, which contains the X and Y attribute. So that I have to import. And these are, I have printed the first five records of the file, which contains the X and Y records. So first five records are printed. Then we have to import the matplotlib library because I want to plot the clusters. Since in K-means clustering, plotting is necessary because we want to show the output in the form of graph. Also, we have to import the K-means header file, which is known as K-means library because we are using the K-means clustering algorithm. So these two are the header files that are necessary. And now we will give the number of cluster in which we want to divide our K-means algorithm. So here I want to divide the attributes into three clusters. So here I have given the N cluster as 3, and in that I want to divide my data frame. So I want to fit the data frame into three clusters, and here I want the number of centroids. So here I will be printing the centroids, means mean values. So here first I will print the mean values and then we will plot the clusters. So these are the three centers that we will get. So these are the three mean values of the centers that we will get after the calculation of all the results. Means after following all the steps, this will be the final centroid values of a clusters. So what are the centroid values? How many steps are being performed? If you want to go in details, then you have to see the numerical video that I have already explained, and link to that numerical will be in the description. Now I want to plot how the graph is being denoted and how many clusters are there and how the points are being plotted. So if I plot the graph, you can see there are three clusters. Blue color dot denote one cluster, yellow color dot denote the other cluster, and the purple color dot denote the third cluster. Since I have used three clusters, these are the three point clusters they are showing, and the red color dots show the mean value or the centroids of the particular clusters. So you can see for the purple, this is the centroid value. For yellow dots, this is the centroid value, and respectively for blue, this is the centroid value. So these three are the centroid value for the particular clusters. And the K-means have been divided the points into three clusters since I have given the three value. Now if you want to divide the cluster values into four cluster, you can do that also. So we will just do that also and check how you can divide the clusters into more clusters. So if I want to do that, you can divide the cluster value into 3, 4 as you want to do that. So here we are giving the cluster value as 4. So the mean value, centroid value will change accordingly. And if again I want to plot that graph also, we can plot it here and get the respective figure. So you can see again the graph is being plotted. They are use 4 different colors. So you can see this is the 4th cluster and the centroid values are different. So this is one cluster, this is other, this is the third one, and this is the fourth one. So you can change the value of a cluster and see the graphs accordingly. So this was a simple example of k-means clustering, how you can use a data set and how you can divide the data points into the given cluster. I hope everyone is clear with the idea. If you have any doubt, you can let me know in the comment section, or you can follow me on Instagram and DM me your doubts there. Thank you for watching the videos. For more such videos, stay tuned on the channel. Make sure you subscribe it and follow me on Instagram. Thank you, everyone.